Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to create a mind map layout using the Blazor Diagram component. In this video, I will show you how to create a mind map layout and customize the nodes and connectors in the layout. You will also see how to align the layout with the horizontal spacing and vertical spacing properties, and how to expand and collapse child nodes. First, I'll open an existing Blazor WebAssembly app, where I have the Blazor Diagram component with height and width properties. If you would like to watch the video on how to create this Blazor app, follow the link provided in the card above. Now, I will run this application to show the initial output. The diagram canvas has been created. Next, I am going to create a mind map layout. Mind mapping is a highly effective way to organize your thoughts organically, without worrying about order and structure. Looking at this image now, it is a mind map layout that represents different categories and requirements in a business planning strategy. To create a similar mind map layout, I will create a data source first by defining a model class named MindMapDetails. And add the fields ID, Label, Parent ID, and Branch. Here, I have set the built-in enum data type, called branch type, which has predefined values like left, subright, and root. Then, I create a list of type mind map details with the name diagram data source. And assign values to the fields ID, Label, Parent ID, and Branch. Each object in this list renders as a node in the mind map layout. The ID field uniquely identifies a node. The Label field value will be displayed as the node's content. The Parent ID field establishes the parent-child relationship between nodes. Say for example, here any object whose ID value is the same as the parent ID value of any object. The former object will be the parent of the latter object. And lastly, branch represents the position of the nodes in the layout. Now, I bind this diagram data source list to the component by defining the data source settings tag and assigning the list to the data source property. To provide the diagram component with the child and parent node information, I map the ID property to the ID field from the data source, and the parent ID property to the parent ID field. Then, I set the layout type by defining the layout tag and setting the type property to the mind map layout to display the business planning chart. You can see that the mind map layout has been created with the provided parent and child nodes. But the nodes are empty. Next, let's see how to display nodes with annotations. To do that, I add the event, node creating, with the event handler, node create. This event will be called whenever a node is created. I define the event handler, node create, which receives the diagram object argument. This argument holds the details of the current node. I will create an instance for the node with the name diagram node and assign the casted object to it. I will also add an instance for the class MindMapDetails and assign the casted diagram node data. Then, I define the annotations property. And assign the label field from the data source to the content property. Now, the nodes are rendered with the defined annotations. To make this layout visually appealing, I am going to set custom heights and widths for the nodes and change the shape of the nodes. I'm also going to fill them with a background color. To do that, I set the node height to 50 pixels and the node width to 150 pixels. To change the default rectangle shape to an ellipse, I define the shape property. And set the shape type to basic. And the shape name to ellipse. As I like to render nodes in different colors, based on their levels in the business planning layout, I modify the existing data source by adding another field, Fill, to the Mind Map Details class. And then I define appropriate values for the Fill field in the data source list. Here, I have set different colors for the different levels. Now, inside the Node Create Event Handler, I define the style of the node. And set the fill and stroke color properties to the fill field from the data source. I also set the stroke width with an appropriate value. Finally, I changed the color of the annotation's content to white. You can see the layout nodes render in ellipse shapes, with different colors and in the defined dimensions. Here, the ellipse shape is applied to all nodes. So next, let me show you how to change the shape of any specific node and apply a custom shape to it. In this example, I am going to set a path shape node to the root node. First, I will check if the current node received in the argument is a root node. If so, I will set the shape type to path. And define the data property with an appropriate value. If you would like to know how to create a node and customize it using different shapes, refer to the video given in the description below. You can see the root node renders with a custom shape. Finally, I would like to customize the connectors as well. So I add the connector creating event. With the event handler, connector create. This event will be triggered when a connector is created. I define the connector create event handler, which receives the diagram object as an argument. I create an instance for the connector. And assign the casted object to it. I set the connector type to Bezier. I set the target decorator to none to display the connectors without any decorator shape. I also changed the color of the connector by defining shape style and setting the stroke color and stroke width properties with appropriate values. Here, I have used if-else loop to set different colors for different levels in the layout. If you want to know how to create connectors and customize them with different segment types and decorator shapes, refer to the video attached in the link above. The layout is now rendered with the customized connectors. By default, the horizontal and vertical space between nodes is 30 pixels. If you would like to customize them, use the vertical spacing and horizontal spacing properties. To demonstrate, I set the horizontal spacing to 90 pixels and the vertical spacing to 50 pixels. I can also set the margin between the layout bounds by defining layout margin. Setting the margin to 20 pixels in all directions. Look at the layout, it is rendered with the defined spacing and margins. Notice, the child nodes are in expand mode by default. Suppose you'd like to collapse the child nodes, simply add the expand and collapse icon to the parent nodes. To achieve this, inside the node create event handler. Define the property expand icon of the current node and create a new diagram expand icon. Set the shape to minus. Height and width to 15 pixels. And corner radius to 10. I will define the position of the expand icon using the offset X and offset Y properties set with appropriate values. Similarly, I'll create a collapse icon and add it to the parent nodes by defining the same properties. You can now collapse the child nodes by clicking the collapse icon of the respective parent node. In this video, you have seen how to create a mind map layout using the Blazor diagram component. You have also seen how to customize the nodes and connectors in the layout and align them using the horizontal and vertical spacing properties. Lastly, you have seen how to expand and collapse the child nodes in the layout. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, do like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.